Christmas Eve to everybody and to puppies that have been outside I don't know how many times this morning already, and they are waiting. They are waiting for their cookies, are you? Yes? Well, I've been up for a while, but I've been... Oh, got a tangle here. I'll have to get that out. Anyway, I haven't been doing much this morning, except I uploaded my video. Well, I had to edit my video first, which I did that about, what time was it? About 4 o'clock this morning? 5 o'clock this morning. And I've been answering messages. And then that song, Animal Crackers in My Soup, popped into my head. You know how when you get a song that's in your head and you can't get it out? And the thing is, I always thought that was a dumb, corny, stupid song. And I'm not a huge Shirley Temple fan. Although I did make my mother-in-law a Shirley Temple porcelain doll, because I used to go to doll making classes when I lived in Virginia, and I used to make really nice porcelain dolls. Anyhow, I was never a big Shirley Temple fan at all, but this song popped into my head, and I don't even know the lyrics to the song. So I went online to look up the lyrics to it, because it's like, well, if I'm going to have this song in my head, I might as well know, you know, what it is that I'm attempting to sing in my head. So, online, they had this YouTube video that I clicked on, because it said, Animal Crackers in My Soup, and then in quotation marks, not quotation marks, parentheses, they had lyrics. So, you know, when you are looking up a song online and it has the lyrics because the person makes the video and they actually type in all the lyrics for you. I watched that whole video. It was the song from the movie with no lyrics. So anyway, I thought, what is the movie that this song is from? Anyway, so I went back into Google search to find out what movie it was, and it was from the movie Curly Top. And I did some research even of some of the actors in that movie, and the actress that plays Mary, her sister, in real life, that lady was, her and her husband, who worked for Disney, they were spies for the United States. So they were the, you know, good spies during World War II to, you know, get information and everything. I did not know that. I did know that there were celebrities in World War II that that they were spies. Anyhow, I did not know that either. So, anyhow, I found the movie, the whole movie, and it's the colorized version. I have to look at my glasses because my kids, they let milk set overnight in their glasses, and I hate that because the milk, you know, it dries and it gets stuck, and I'm using one hand right now, and it's hard to get down there and really clean it out. But anyway, so yeah, the movie is Curly Top, so I started watching it, and then the dogs wanted to go outside, so now I might as well wash these dishes up first, and I'm going to need two hands here pretty soon with these glasses, so I'm just going to let that soak. I have to get into my refrigerator here and pull out eggs because I need to get my eggs boiled to make deviled eggs. And I won't start a lot of the cooking for Christmas Eve until later this afternoon because we eat late on Christmas Eve. We wait until the first showing of A Christmas Story, and that usually, I think, comes on at 8 o'clock. So by 7:30, I usually have everything all prepared, and I have a huge buffet of food here on the island, and everybody just, you know, gets plates. They help themselves. And then we go into the family room over there, and we all watch A Christmas Story at least twice before we go to bed. I do have cans of Coke. I keep a stock of Coke because I have a lot of Coke drinkers in my house. I'm not really a big pop drinker in general. I really don't pop, soda, whatever you want to call it. I really don't drink a lot of carbonated beverages. Only a couple times a year I'll do it. And like I'll do it at Christmas. So anyhow, that's what I need to do now. Is I need to, this one's empty, I only had 5 cans, so I need another one. I need to get some of these cans in the fridge so they can be getting nice and cold. But before I head upstairs, I'm waiting for my eggs to boil, because you boil the eggs, you bring it up to a boil, you let them boil for a minute, put the lid on, turn the heat off, and walk away. And 15 minutes later, your eggs are finished. So anyhow, they're now beginning to boil a little bit. I mean, it's not a full rolling boil yet, so I can't count the minute just yet. And I have my coffee on. I washed all my dishes. I cleaned my refrigerator off. Stainless steel. I like stainless steel appliances. Very difficult to keep clean. That's all I'm saying. All my pop is in here. I've got, I don't know, I think I counted like 17, 18 cans. And I guess while I'm waiting for those to boil, I'm going to get off this camera, because now I'm noticing my dishwasher needs to be cleaned. And the door over there where the girlies are constantly licking, I might as well go clean that too. And that's all I'm doing today. I'm not doing no work today except making food. And I just got done talking to Joe. And this is going to be the first Christmas that I don't have all my kids with me on Christmas Eve. Carly's coming, but Joe and Melissa are not. They're going to stay at home because they're having their little Christmas today, or tonight I should say, because they're coming over here in the morning, and then they've got to drive to Philadelphia like after our brunch to go spend Christmas, the afternoon dinner and all that with her family. And so, this will be the first year that our normal tradition of having all kinds of appetizers and, you know, watching The Christmas Story. I mean, we're still going to have food. It's just not going to be the normal food that we normally have. We're still going to watch Christmas Story, but it's just going to be minus some people this year. Carly's coming, and she's probably bringing Mike, I'm sure, because, you know, he's not going back to Illinois for Christmas, so he's going to be here. So he can't sit home alone. She's got to bring him here. So anyhow, I know that life goes on, and this is a part of life. And I'm just glad at least Carly's coming, because, you know, now that she's out on her own, you know, life isn't going to be as it was. But you know what? For me and my brothers, we did the same thing. And so now I know how my mom and my dad felt when the nest was emptying out and people starting their own lives and doing their own things. And, you know, Joe and Melissa, they need to have their own Christmases. So, and I understand that. I'm good with that. It's just, you know, it's the first year. I'm sure after this year, I'll get over it. So, I'm coming in here to get ready for today. And one of the things that I thought about making, I'm not wearing contacts today. I wore my glasses. One of the things I'm going to make today for dinner is I'm going to make latkes, because things were so crazy with Thanksgiving, getting ready to go on vacation, and all of that. I'm huffing and puffing because I've been running around downstairs. All the stuff that I had to do, last minute things getting ready for Christmas, because I get all my Christmas shopping and all that stuff done early. So, anyhow, I didn't really celebrate Hanukkah like we normally do, and Carly took my candles because she wouldn't go out and buy her own candles. However, I did have extra candles. I mean, I had more candles I still could have lit our menorah too, because I had a bunch on hand. However, it was just too crazy, and I just decided, you know, one holiday at a time. I like when Hanukkah usually falls at Christmas time, because even though they're two holidays, I can work on it as one holiday. You see what I'm saying? But you had Thanksgiving, Hanukkah in November, the end of November, and then you have Christmas and then New Year's. It was just too much. So anyhow, we didn't celebrate Hanukkah. That's my whole point. And so we didn't even eat any of our foods that we normally eat. So we had no lackeys. Brian was so funny. He said to me a few days ago, he says, "Mom, how come you didn't make a brisket? We haven't had brisket." And I said, "Well, because I always do that at Hanukkah, and you know it's this time of year that I normally do brisket. I make beef brisket throughout the year, but there's many different ways to make beef brisket. But the Jewish way of making beef brisket," that's what he was asking. And he was like, "We didn't have brisket, we didn't have lackeys." And I said, "I know." I said, "Maybe, you know, next weekend I'll do a brisket and do lackeys and all of that." Well, I was thinking about it last night, and I told Harry, you know, instead of trying to make potato salad, I was going to do like potato salad. Instead of mashed potatoes, I was going to do potato salad because we got the ham and everything. And I thought about it, and I said, "You know what? I should just make lackeys." And I told Harry that, and he said, "You know what? I was just thinking about that a couple days ago." Well, last week or whatever it was. He said, "I was thinking about that, that we did not have any lackeys." And I said, "Well, right, because we didn't celebrate Hanukkah." And he's like, "We need to have lackeys." He said, "So I'm fine with that if you want to make lackeys today." I'm just cleaning up my mess. I got my eggs peeled for deviled eggs, which I'm going to get to that here in just a bit. I decided to make my Christmas stollen. I didn't make that yet because all last week, as you guys know, I was busy making my Christmas cookies. And we're going to have stollen with our breakfast brunch tomorrow. So on the menu tomorrow is a breakfast casserole I'm making. I usually, when I do like a brunch like that, I'll make strata. I even make strata, you know, sometimes just for dinner because we like it. But I'm not going to do that. I'm doing a different recipe that I saw somebody posted on Facebook, and it looks so good. And I posted it on my Facebook too. So I'm going to try that one. And then I'm making that French toast that I was telling you with the cream cheese. I got my cream cheese getting room temperature and with the oranges. And I called my mom. I was talking to my mom, and she said, "Why are you going to put a teaspoon of orange extract in there?" She goes, "You know, that's going to be really strong. And then to put orange zest in there, and then if you end up putting a little bit of the juice from the oranges too." And I said, "Well, because when you make cream cheese mince, you put a teaspoon of peppermint extract in." And then I started thinking, I thought, "Oh, but wait a minute, you put a bunch of powdered sugar in there too to make it like a Play-Doh consistency, if you've ever made cream cheese mince before." So I was thinking of that. And with this too, to sweeten up the cream cheese, I'm probably going to have to put a little bit of powdered sugar in. Not a lot. I'm going to start out with just like 2 tablespoons of it just to see, you know, if that's sweet enough. And I'll just test it as I go. I don't have a recipe for this. I'm having to wing it and figure it out on my own. But I will. Even if I fail this time, I'll figure it out the next time. So, now that my kitchen's about cleaned up, I need to go dry my hair from taking my shower. My stollen, I just put it in. I've got 2 of them in there. And then when I come down, I'll finish those deviled eggs. Okay, I'll tell you how I made this cream cheese mixture now. I did about 3/4 of a teaspoon of orange extract because I had to adjust it. I had Harry taste it, and he said he really couldn't taste too much of the orange. I put orange zest in it. I put in the juice of one orange and just mixed it all up. And that's the cream mixture that I'm going to be using for my French toast. And there's my stool in. And finished my eggs. And to give it a nice Christmassy look, I usually sprinkle paprika on it anyway, but to give it some green with the red, I put on some dill. I just put a little bit in my hand and took my fingers and just sprinkled a little here and there. So now I got the green and the red on my eggs. And that's it for me. I need to clean up this kitchen because Harry's coming in now to do the shrimp. He's feeling much better. You're feeling much better, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yep. He's been out and about. He went and saw his mom today. And so, I gotta clean up those dishes, put those away, and put these away in here. And girlies are over there bummed out because they thought they were gonna get something to snack on. They thought stuff was gonna drop to the floor and there was nothing for them. So, anyway, that's it until a little bit later. Now I've gotta clean up, right, girlies? Lucy, look at you. You are so funny. Are you bored? Is that your bored look? Or is that your I would like some food look? You're not even moving. You're like a statue. You're not even blinking your eyes. There you go. It's snowing a little bit. And getting very windy and cold. We had to start a fire. Carly's going to try. That's the thing that I had yesterday. And tell me what it tastes like.
Tastes like strawberry and chocolate.
But doesn't it taste like white chocolate that's got like strawberry flavoring in it?
A little bit. I think it comes everywhere.
So you like it?
Not bad. There's what? Michael.
And Michael is picking through here. See, here's, you gotta try. Since you're a fish eater, let me show you. It wasn't that. It has like an octopus or a squid on it.
Yeah, that's not me.
Oh wait, here they are. I think these are them. Okay, now that looks like fish, don't it? Don't that look like a fish fillet? A picture of a fish fillet? See the picture?
Kinda.
Usually the pictures tell you what it is. And then, so see, that would be an octopus.
Okay, this one looks weird. I'll try this one.
All right. I have Josiah eat the last two tomorrow.
Do you want to?
It's probably just slimy. I don't know.
You know, you can try some of that.
Oh, wow.
What's it smell like?
Soy sauce.
Soy sauce?
What do you think?
What's it taste like? What's it taste like? Is that the octopus one?
Yeah.
Does it taste like octopus?
It tastes like those salt and vinegar chips.
Oh, really?
But it's got like the fishy taste to it too.
Oh, okay. For cookies and candies, and cheese and crackers, turkey, ham, shrimp, deviled eggs, Romanian green beans, mozzarella sticks. We have latkes. Carly's pulling the rest out, and we got to bring those buns over, and then it'll be time to eat.
Well, how about the rest of the
time to eat? Girlies, you're gonna have to get out
what
of the way.
What?
Huh? That's cheddar. Yes. That's Swiss. Jeez. I think that's Havarti. That's Gouda, and that's provolone.
I don't think I'll
try this one for
the holes.
What? That's
Gouda.
I like Swiss cheese.
Michael?
Yeah, I'm waiting for the initial rush to die.
And the girlies are waiting for food too.
Honey Boo Boo, or the mom, she was upset because South Park made fun of them with their show, and she said they made it look trashy. If you're gonna put yourself on a show like that, be prepared to be made fun of.
It's a great training.
When you make skitty and what?
Skitty and butter.
How do you make it again?
Take a big tub of country crock and squirt a huge bottle of ketchup, throw in the microwave, and there you go. That's their sauce.
Chloe, you're really wanting food, aren't you?
Right.
They showed the South Park thing where they were making fun of her, and she's cooking, and then she turns her head and she's like, her favorite foods are skitty and butter. She likes drinking Red Bull and Mountain Dew. But see, she literally, for her kid, when she goes to the pageant, she loads her up on Red Bull and Mountain Dew, so she's all wired. And for a 6-year-old, and then eating a ton of sketty and butter, that's not good for your health. Yeah, she's running through.
Oh, everybody's
got their own, you know. So they do eat sketty and butter. I double triple dog dare ya. So, Merry Christmas!